Hi, today I am answering a query. Why am I sitting in Kodaikanal and answering a query? Good question. Because a question came in Kodaikanal that a young boy, maybe about 25, 26 years of age, who reads up a little bit on personal finance, asked me a question saying, I'm so young, I have to put money in equity. Should I put money into debt at all? Good question, very aggressive. And I said, it's a question which is very difficult for me to answer because it depends on you. And it is a lot about your personality. So I asked him, where does your father invest? So he said, my father has only bank fixed deposits and maybe worth about 40, 50 lakhs, but only bank deposits and post office schemes. And that's what he does. All that money he has earned is there. And he runs some shop and he does some business. So 40, 50 lakhs is what he has apart from a house. And that is going to be his retirement plan. Also, his father is about 60 years of age and he has no plans to retire before the age of 70. The family very badly hurt by the lockdown. Their shop's revenue has gone down. Yes, so those things happen. And this was a fair question, right? If you are 20 years of age and you are saying that you need this money only while at retirement, which means you have got 30, 40, 50 years to go, should you put money in debt? So my answer to him was, very technically speaking and theoretically speaking, no, you need not put any money at all in debt. But understand the following things. You are a first-time equity investor and your father may not understand equity and he may find the fluctuations very scary. So he may not have heard about equity, so he'll talk to somebody else who may not also have any experience in equity. But he'll tell you, oh, during Harshad Mehta's scam, people lost money. During Ketan Parekh, people lost money, blah, blah, blah. And, you know, somebody could scare the hell out of you, of your father. And your father may decide that equity is a terrible way to invest. And even though you're well qualified and earning, this boy is an engineer who is doing his part-time MBA. So since you're earning well, he may tolerate your mistakes for some time. But whether he will tolerate it for a long time, if you lose money, is something which you have to decide. Now let us assume that this kid starts investing and he puts money only in equity. Let's say next 4 years his returns are nothing or close to nothing. So he is putting in the money in an SIP form and he's earning 6% or 5% return is what he gets in equity over 4 years. What is likely to happen is his father will say, see, I told you, you have to put in national savings certificate. This is the return you would have got. You would have got at least 7%. Here you're getting 4%, which is much worse. You're taking risk. You're not getting any return. So, right, some nagging by the parent is possible. Some nagging by friends and relatives and colleagues say, "Arey, see, you're getting nothing. Why are you invested there?" So the question is, will you have the conviction? I have the conviction, right? Nobody needs to sell equity to me. Nobody needs to sell equity to the guy who owns this house, that is Shamshekhar, right? You don't need that. We don't need to be told why we should invest in equities. We knew about equities. We started early. We have benefited by investing in equities, right? So all these things have happened. So therefore, I have to sell equity to you and you have to sell equity to your father. I have to tell you it's a great idea, you should put money. But remember, you can do a 10-year equity fund and not get any return or get return less than a debt fund. Right, these things can happen in good quality funds that you can get. But remember, you cannot get a pathetic return if you put money in SIP form, because the markets will go down, markets will go up, everything will happen. Then suddenly one day when the market goes up, you will be a huge beneficiary because of your patience, right? So those things will also happen. It's not that it won't happen. But do you have the conviction? Do you have the people around you who will support you saying it's a good decision, stick around and you will get money? Because for 10 years, if you have not made much money, believe me, in the 11th or 12th year will be a complete breakout and you will get some 78% return or 72% return in that 1 year, which will dramatically improve your total return. But if you panicked and sold in the 9th year, waiting for the markets to go up, and this happens in shares, this happens in funds, it happens in all these places, you will lose patience exactly at the wrong time. Who will prevent you from redeeming at the wrong time? Do you have good advisors? That is a very important thing to ask. And do you have your own conviction? How will you handle parental and peer pressure saying you should remove money? This is completely from a psychological point of view. Apart from that, what is the first step that you should do is, since your father invests only in debt, ask him also to do a small SIP, maybe 3,000 rupees, maybe 5,000 rupees. Tell him, think of this as money lost. You also start and I will also start. Let us start with small amounts. You also take some risk. I also take some risk. Let's see how it is. Don't ask your father to put more than 3,000 rupees a month, because 50 lakhs is the total corpus that he has. So tell him, let us put it for 5 years and then have a look. Maybe by that time he will also develop some conviction, you will also develop some conviction. So you put in a Sensex index fund, let him put in a Nifty index fund. The correlation is very close to one, so it doesn't really matter. But at least you think you have more diversification. Or you put in a top 500 fund and your father puts in a top 100 fund, right? So something like that. So create some such portfolio for both of you. Look at it regularly, talk with him, discuss with him, create a small group of investors who are all doing some SIPs and talk regularly. That's very useful and very helpful. And what about your short-term goals? What about, let's say you want to get married at 27, you're now 23. Then how do you manage? Or you're now 26, you want to get married at 30. So 3-4 years later, you have a marriage goal. You have to want to buy a car after 4 years. You want to make a down payment for that. And, you know, some of those goals, some goals which may not be negotiable. You may want to buy a house, but that goal may be negotiable in terms of date. Your car buying could be negotiable in terms of date. Your two-wheeler buying may not be negotiable in terms of date beyond 2-3 months. You want a new bike, right? So see, though, for those goals which are short term, which is less than 7 years, around 5 years, 6 years, also I would put something like 70-80% in debt and 20% in equity, waiting for a kicker to happen. And if it doesn't happen, I may still go and achieve my goal because my debt has done reasonably well, right? So some of those things I will do. So yes, for short term goals I will. For needing money for some other short term goal or for an emergency fund, I will create some debt. For maybe helping your parents in case of an emergency, I will do it. But in your case, I won't do it because your father has a debt in bank deposit. Make sure that you break it into 2-3 banks, smaller amounts, so that if you want to break, you can break one deposit, and up to 5 lakhs is insured. So if you're getting into a weak bank, which means a non-SBI, non-Bank of Baroda kind of non-PSU bank, or some if you're putting money in HDFC Bank, ICICI Bank, State Bank of India, Axis Bank, Yes Bank, your money is reasonably safe because they are all well-managed banks today, at least. So then your father is putting that money, break that into those small, those 3-4 banks. Make sure that you have e-access to one of those banks, so that in case of an emergency, you are to break it and you're out of station, you can break it from whichever location you are, so that your father can access that money, right? So to dumb up some of those things for your dad's money, put some money in your mom's name, put some money in your dad's name, reduce the impact of tax, do those things and show your dad the benefits of getting financially savvy. Once you do those things, then you start doing an equity fund. Start doing an equity fund for you and your father and see how it goes. Play it by the year. But this is exactly what you should not be doing, is panic and remove. Panic maybe, get scared maybe, but getting scared, everybody does get scared, but panicking is not compulsory. Don't panic because you are putting a small amount of money. After you develop some conviction, you can start increasing the amounts of money, and that's the way to go and start investing. But little bit of money in debt is not too bad, especially showing it to your father, how you're deferring the taxation on that. All that is very useful. Thank you.